Hello, my darlings. This is Mr. Willem with his phallic gargoyle. I've been having trouble with audio, and it's really beginning to piss me off, but I was going to delete all of the videos I'm doing where my lips and my words, my vocals, don't coincide, but that's just boring. So I'm really hoping that this doesn't happen on Tuesday. Tuesday will be the 18th, I believe. 18th of May. I will be having ST Joshi will be coming here. He is the editor of my new book. And that book is called The Tangled Muse. Probably can't see that. And ST is my editor, and he wrote the introduction. The book is to be published by Centipede Press. Tangled Muse. And so we have 150 autograph sheets to autograph ST and I. So he's going to be here Tuesday night to do that with me, and he has promised to come and sit in front of my webcam and let me interview him for 2 10-minute interviews. So I'm really looking forward to that. So I hope, you know, when I interview the world's leading Lovecraft scholar, that my audio is not screwed up. That's just really annoying. I'm really excited about my book. It's called The Tangled Muse. One of my favorite novels is by Henry James, and it's called The Tragic Muse. And I've always wanted to write a story called The Tangled Muse, and I tried to write that story for many years, and finally I wrote it. And I've always wanted a book of my fiction called The Tangled Muse, and so this hardcover from Centipede Press will be that book. Very excited. And I have some wonderful illustrations for it. This is the illustration for the title story. It's a Virgil Finley illustration. And it's just, isn't that great? It's perfect. It's astonishing that I found perfect illustrations for this book. I have another story called Born in Strange Shadow, which is kind of a riff on H.P. Lovecraft's Pickman's Model. And it mentions, in Pickman's Model, there is a painting that Pickman did of a hanged witch. And beneath her there are these ghouls. And I mentioned that painting in my story. And so I found this wonderful Virgil Finley painting or illustration, and it's perfect. There's the ghoul and the hanged witch. It's just amazingly perfect. This is another Virgil Finley illustration that we will be using. I want the book to have a feel like it is a product of the Victorian era of that it could have been published in London in 1890. And so we have filled the book with lots and lots of wonderful artwork by Aubrey Beardsley. This is one such illustration. And then I have this great illustration by Frank Uchtel. This appeared, this is one of the illustrations that he did for H.P. Lovecraft's The Fungi from Yuggoth. So that is going to be in my book. We have this delicious illustration to illustrate one of my stories of Nyarlathotep. And of course we have some illustrations by the magnificent Madame Talbot. So that is a book that I have already finished, and it is completed. I am almost finished writing a collection of what will be my Tales of Nyarlathotep, The Crawling Chaos. And this is a book that will be published by Mythos Books. And I have one more story to write for it, which I I now have almost 6,000 words. I think it's going to be a novelette. I hope so. And it's called The Strange Dark One. Strange Dark One. Which is a reference from the fungi from Yuggoth concerning Nyarlathotep. And the beginning of this story begins with a poem, which is an unpublished poem by William Davis Manley of Sesqua Valley. So I thought, in conclusion of this vlog, I would read this poem. So here it is. I have looked through black trees to the dry and dead moon, there in a darkened sky, a place of ultimate omission, which expands overhead like some cauldron of nightmare, an abyss of night. I don't know if I want an abyss of night and nightmare so close together, so I may have to revise that. Sorry. Overhead, a yawning universe seethes, as if to devour this world and we who creep insignificantly on it. We who stumble and find no hold of sanity. A chill madness seeps down from the darkness. It touches the hoary old stones of this unholy house in the valley, where chaos and lunacy dance, where they move in an atmosphere haunted by the mockery there on his mask, his facade of imperial midnight. He offers his hand to our tongue. He is, of course, Nyarlathotep, and the wild beasts are said to lick his hands. A lovely, lovely image. So, that is my poem, my new story, which I hope to have finished this month, but I'm not certain if that will happen. I wasn't able to write anything today. But I had dinner with S.T. Joshi today, so what the hell. So tune in Tuesday night. I will have two interviews with S.T. Joshi, and he will talk about some of his new books. We will talk about H.P. Lovecraft, and it'll be fabulous. I love S.T. He's such a wonderful friend, and he has done